And welcome, Patrick.
Hello, everyone. My name is Patrick. I'm an OSINT investigator in the brand protection area, and my background is in the private investigations. The previous background where I conducted covered and undercovered online and offline investigations, and OSINT investigations into the corporate and criminal networks. And at the moment, I'm doing online to offline investigations of counterfeit networks and other malicious networks. And my future path is as an all sorts of cyber investigations analyst. And I want to do more covered and undercovered online to offline investigations into the brand protection area. So my presentation today will cover investigating phishing emails. And in this adventure, I will present a typology of phishing emails. It's not a comprehensive one, it's only a short one, detailing some of the phishing attacks that I encountered in my investigations. Then I will define the scope. This will be in the brand protection area, the workflows I'm using. And thirdly, I will discuss about the reactive frameworks, and I will point out the manual investigation step by step, and versus the automated tools I'm using, and also the OSINT community is using. And I will have two case studies to present. Fourthly, I have the proactive frameworks, some examples of scanning and monitoring platforms, and some tools, and a case study. And finally, I will discuss the reporting issues and the enforcing actions I'm undertaking, and I recommend for the clients and other stakeholders. All right, so what's in the waters? So the first category is walling attack. This is targeting the C-level of an organization, of a company. Then the second category is the spear phishing attack, that is targeting a specific company, a specific brand, a specific also personnel from the company, department, so on. Third category is mass email phishing. It's targeting diverse persons, and the bad actors may have access to your data through the leaked databases, such as the current Facebook data leak, and they have access to your email. They can do a phishing email attack, or a smishing one, via text, or a phishing attack via voice call. I'm not gonna touch these types of phishing attacks, such as smishing or phishing. I'm only focusing on phishing emails in this presentation. The fourth category is targeted email phishing injecting malware. It's a venomous fish associated with this. It's also called a vampire fish. And there is an Israeli cybersecurity company, very known in the field, associated with this type of fish, the fourth one in my presentation. And the last one is the lion fish, which is also a venomous fish, and it's associated with a biting a phishing email, which is trying to lure a victim, and for example, to make you to click on a link, or to do a donation for a charity, and so on. So before any phishing expedition, you have to prepare yourself. You have to know your operating system, either it's Windows or Linux, And you can see the differences between them. On the right is an image taken from Lisa Forte from Twitter. You can follow her. And secondly, you have to set your and to know your operational security procedures. So VMs, VPNs, SOC puppets, browser security, mobile security, as Finder discussed in the morning. And the third step will be to set your operating workspace, to know your workflows and tools you are using. And the fourth step will be to capture any evidence you find and to document each step you are doing. I'm using and I recommend using Hunchly for this, the paid version. Also try to do screenshots and to document what steps you are going to follow in each investigation. When a big fish attack is happening, then there are several ways to bring it to the shore. So there are two main frameworks. So the reactive one and the proactive one. The reactive one, which I'm going to discuss right now, is based on the manual step by step. You can do it from your browser. So first you are going to analyze the email header, and you are following some steps, the common steps in an investigation, looking at the WIS records and looking at the source code, subdomain enumeration, and so on and so forth. For example, here we have a reactive phishing email targeting a Netflix account. So you are going to look at the email from who is coming from. You are going to see also to whom you are going to reply to, and you see here the domains. And for example, you are taking the second domain, alcoholism.net, and you are going to research and to see. And I'm going to show you immediately how you can do it. All right, so let me show you here using my VM. Oh yeah, so here is an example of a framework, which is a localized framework, OSINT framework.pl. And you can start, it's also based on the OSINT framework, the general one, and this is a localized one, and you have to do some investigation following these categories here. So this is how I'm organizing my workflows and my tools in the browser. So I'm putting every tool I'm using, and I'm going to put the domain name into each of the tool. And for example, for this domain, alcoholism.net, I'm using the forcepoint.com, which is also showing me the link, the redirecting URL, where it's going, the IP address and the address. And also another tool for this is the phishcheck.me I'm using, and you can trace the links here. And you have the IP addresses, also related submissions, resources, and the redirects here. Then I'm going to use Shodan, Senses, and other related tools for this, in order to investigate the domain name. So this is one of my workflow that I'm using. All right. The next case study, a reactive case study, is about Amazon phishing email. It's an Amazon email that I received about my account a few months ago, and I started to investigate who is behind it. And I'm going to show you the image immediately and to walk you through this more closely. So this is the header of the email I received. Amazon from Amazon Web Services. We have a subdomain, a domain there. We have the timestamp, and we have an attachment and that said, your statement report is in an attachment we have provided. So one of my my first step is to look at the domain. I'm going to scan the domain with the virus total. I'm seeing that it's malicious, for example. One engine detected it. Then I'm going to I'm going in my virtual machine. I'm creating a sandbox environment, and I'm going to upload this file. I'm going to see the hash of the file in the virus total, for example. And I'm also seeing that it contains a malware, a Trojan, a fish, and so on. Then for this domain, I'm going to look at the DNS records. I'm going to see, for example, the SOA record. I'm going to look at the company, the hosting company, which is a company from Bulgaria, a cheap company, and so on. I'm going to see, for example, then in the third step, the who is the registrant of the domain. So here I was lucky because this was not protected by privacy services, and I could see that the registrant name is one Linda from Indonesia. I have the phone number and the email, and the email provides me another domain here that I'm going to investigate further. I'm looking at the subdomains. Then I'm going to use the URL scan.io, and I'm seeing that this subdomain is malicious. Going then to other subdomain, going to see the IP and also the hosting provider. And then for each domain, I'm checking also the SSL certificates. And for this one, I was able to see that the domain, the certificate was issued for another domain, which is connected to other domains. And I'm going to check every domain, and I saw that five of them, which are in Indonesian, are leading to an organization in Nairobi, Kenya, which is Hakina Ukweli. It's in Swahili, and it's meaning justice and truth. And the story behind this is that this is an organization fighting for human rights abuses and corruption in Nairobi, Kenya. And I'm going further to research on the social media, discovering the social media accounts, checking the YouTube channel, what they are doing, checking the donations, checking everything I can find about this organization, and also other domains and subdomains here. For example, what else they are doing. They were also involved in some Netflix phishing attacks, also looking at the IP addresses and hosting companies, and then checking also via the search engines for the domain names. And I succeeded to find out one Facebook account of one person from Indonesia. Then I'm going to the phone numbers and emails on the website. The content information is very important also on the website, and can lead you to different different persons and other connected activity. And I discovered here some of the people behind it. There are two brothers here linked via the phone number from Nairobi, Kenya. They also have some connected activity on their Facebook accounts, and also the phone number. One of them is leading to a guy in Rwanda who has the technical knowledge, and also I'm going to investigate what IT knowledge it has, the code he's specialized on, and other things. So what's the story here? Because beyond this technical information and investigation, you have to build up a story for your client, and you have to understand what's the movement here. So this organization needs money to fight against corruption in Nairobi, Kenya. So they have to rely upon these kinds of attacks to collect money to finance their activity there. So it's something common in Africa and also in Eastern Europe or in Asia Pacific area, East Asia, where some of the networks are doing this kind of attacks to finance other activities. All right, so I'm going back to my presentation, and I'm going to show you some of the proactive frameworks that I'm using. One of them is a commercial version of domain tools, Iris. I'm also using Phishing, and I recommend it. One is the open source version, DNS Twist, for checking domain names. The third one is Shodan. I'm using also the commercial version of Shodan to monitor IPs. On the social media side, I'm using Twitter, Yuck, Hunter, TweetDeck, and some of the Telegram databases and tools to monitor the Telegram activity. For example, via the Telegram, I succeeded to reach out to one the Telegram account, which is displaying his desktop and showing some of the Netflix accounts here, IP addresses of the victims. And from this image, you can spot some information that can lead you to valuable information about the target. So we have his Yahoo email on the left side. We have also some of the IP addresses. We have an Amazon cloud account. We have an application he's using, hashkiller.io. And we also we have to check any bit of information here. We also have the Yandex account here. So this can provide valuable information. And by monitoring social media accounts, social media channels, for example, on Telegram, you can see and spot valuable information and about the targets. All right, just before I'm ending, I'm just going to show you quickly some of my proactive tools and some examples on the VM. So for a proactive domain monitoring, you can use DNS Twist. You can try to scan, for example, for a domain, and it's giving you some available domains here, IP addresses, DNS records. And you can also look for the Pony Code domain name. For example, you can try to see how the phishing actors are thinking when they are registering domain names. For example, you can transform here with this tool from Pony Code to Unicode to international domain name, and you can see that this quite quite difficult to spot for a common individual when he is receiving an email and is not educated, you know, to detect this kind of phishing emails. We have another tool which is called DNS Twister. That report is also an anti-phishing domain name search engine. We have another one, Phishy Domains. You can also use, for example, for PayPal, here a search, and it's giving you some of the current phishing attacks in the last 24 hours. And I'm also recommending the Fisheye and the Iris from Domain Tools. So what you are going to do with all the information you are collecting? So for a client, for example, it's important you know to enforce on the domains. So you are using some templates and you are going to the host providers and you want to take down, you know, the phishing domains. You also can report to the Cisco Fish Tank and share with the community, with the CyberSec and OSINT community, which is recommendable, and also in the virus total, you can report there any URLs, any phishing emails. For Microsoft, you can report to Microsoft, Google, or Amazon. There are some specific links where you can report any attempt of phishing attack. I've reported some to Amazon, but I didn't receive anything back. Sometimes it's taking time, so you have to have patience. All right, so this was my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it, and you can follow me on Twitter. You can ask me. I'm not having a wider presence on the social media, but you can always reach out to me, and I will respond to you.
Awesome.
Thank you so much for that. That was really great. You have quite a few questions, actually. Do you want to start Atomic or should I?
Sure. So I think you've kind of gone over this over the course of your talk, but what do you specifically do personally with the information you collect from these phishing emails? Do you just report or do you do something more?
Yeah, now it depends on the scope I have. For example, when a client is defining the scope as we are going after the network behind it, behind the phishing domain or behind the phishing email, I'm going to find out the network, the people behind it, their organizations, and I'm providing online to offline information. This is going to the law enforcement. And when the scope is online enforcement, for example, I'm going to enforce on them. I'm sending the information to the hosting providers or to other companies.
Mm-hmm. And are there any links for these orgs possibly? I know someone was asking about the organizational links and if you could provide them.
Of course. I have included them in my notes. And I will share with you my presentation, and I have more information on my notes. I have also detailed my steps, my workflows there, and I have links to all of them.
Perfect.
Awesome. There was, I think, was there another question?
Yes.
That just came in.
You want me to ask it?
Yes.
Are technical newbies able to investigate phishing emails easily? Are there certain skills you should have before investigating?
Well, yeah. I'm quite new to the cybersecurity. Previously, I was in the private investigations, and I've learned some skills, you know, conducting background checks, other kind of skills. And when I, you know, when I tried, when I got into the cybersec issues, I've learned everything by myself. I followed the, you know, the OSINT community on Twitter, on Discord, and other sites, and you have a lot to learn from them. I mean, from every person here. And I've learned some of them. I mean, some of the investigations are easy. Depends on the targets, you know, on the bad guys behind. They are not hiding. They have poor operational security, but some of them are really, really complicated, and you spend a lot of time on them. Especially when you have malicious code, there are some encoded code scripts, and you have to understand the code. You have to understand everything you are doing. It's important, and when you don't know something, go ask for that help. Yeah, I hope I responded to your question, and if not, please send me a message, and I will try to respond at my best.
Right. We've had one little question trickle in, and this might be a personal question, so feel free to not answer it. But who pays you to do this this type of activity?
Well, I'm working in a brand protection company, a global brand protection company. We also have a tool, a platform actually, a state-of-the-art platform in monitoring several modules. We are monitoring marketplaces, social media platforms, and websites. And we are working with top companies from the Fortune 500. So the high value brands are paying us for protecting their brands.
Awesome.